Joining us is Dr. Joe Clark, urologic surgeon at Penn State Health. We are going to talk about aquablation therapy. Definitely a new term for me. So can you explain what that is and how it differs from other treatments for things such as, say, an enlarged prostate?
Right. Well, most of the traditional forms of surgery for treating men with urinary symptoms due to an enlarged prostate involve passing a scope through the urethra and using some kind of energy to remove prostate tissue. And whether that's a little cutting loop that we can whittle away little pieces of prostate tissue, or it's a laser to vaporize tissue, or it's a little button to use electrical cautery to vaporize tissue, they all involve some form of energy to remove prostate tissue. Aquablation is a little different because we use a non-thermal, high-pressure water jet to remove prostate tissue, and it can be removed quickly.
That's interesting. Water, that's so interesting. What are some of the benefits compared to other treatments?
I think the benefit is that it can be, the prostate tissue can be removed relatively quickly. Then the patients are under anesthesia a shorter amount of time, and that's always good for the patient.
Who would be a good candidate for this? And then how is this procedure typically performed?
Well, because the prostate tissue can be removed fairly quickly, I believe that the best candidates are patients with larger prostates, where the traditional methods may take a longer period of time. And again, the patients are under anesthesia a short amount of time, that will decrease complication rates and help with the recovery. The way we actually do this is quite involved. We first put an ultrasound probe into the rectum so we can monitor the prostate in real time. Then we pass the scope with the water jet nozzle at the tip. And then it's very involved. We use a console. We mark out how much of the prostate tissue to remove from here to here at disc depth. But once all that's done, we just press the pedal, and it takes about 8 minutes, and we can see the water jet actually removing the prostate tissue, and you're done. Now, after you're done with the water jet therapy, you do have to put in a scope to look for any bleeding and take care of that, or if there's any ragged edges to take care of that.
So interesting. What is the recovery like with aquablation?
Well, it's typically an overnight stay, so patients have the surgery and they get a special catheter into the bladder that will run irrigation fluid through to make sure that there's not a lot of bleeding or clots that plug up that catheter. And usually the next day, the urine is fairly clear and we're able to discharge them with the catheter. Some people remove the catheter the next day, but I'm usually more conservative, and they go home with a catheter and have a catheter removed a few days later.
Very interesting. Thank you, Dr. Clark. Nice to have you on the show with us today. For more information, or if you would like to make an appointment with Penn State Health, call 717-913-2893.